Hello everyone, welcome to video lectures on data mining and data warehouse, module 1, basic concept. My name is Narayan Naik, assistant professor, department of ISE, Canara Engineering College, Bantwal. The contents of the first modules are, so we will discuss the basic concept, data warehousing, a multi-tier architecture, data warehouse models, enterprise warehouse, data mart, and virtual warehouses. Extraction, transformation, loading. So after that, data queue. So in that, multi-dimensional data models, stars, snowflakes, packed constellation models. Schema for multidimensional data model and dimensions. The role of concept hierarchies, measures and their categorization and computation. And last one, typical OLAP operations. The data warehouse. So we should define like this. Data warehousing is a process for assembling and managing data from various sources for the purpose of gaining a single detailed view of an enterprise. Similarly, a data warehouse is a repository of information collected from multiple sources stored under a unified schema and which usually resides at a single site. So both definition meaning is simple. So we should collect the information from the various files such as local database, and we should keep in a unified. So that is a single detailed. So which will get every aspect of data. So we should access and search it in the entire schema. So that is called as a database. So according to the author, so we should take it. So actual data warehouse is a subject oriented. So we can say that subject oriented. So organized around major subject such as customer, product, sales, so and so. So here, rather than concentrating on the day-to-day operation and transaction processing of an organization, a data warehouse always focuses on the modeling and analysis of the data decision maker. So that's why, hence, the data warehouse typically which provides a simple and concise view of particular subject issues by excluding data and which are not useful in the decision support process. So that's why our data warehouse is a subject oriented. Then we say that a data warehouse is a integrated. So constructed by integrating multiple heterogeneous data sources such as relational database, flat file or on online transaction, OLTP records. So we know that all the flat file which we are collecting the data and finally we need to integrate it. So data cleaning and data integration technique which are applied to ensure the consistency in naming conventions, encoding structure, attribute measures, whatever, so we can take it. So that's why our data warehouse is integrated. Similarly, we'll continue that data warehouse is a time variant. So why time variant means operational database which contains a current value data. So one more data storage is that ODS, operational data storage. So that database which always contains the current value data, but whereas this warehouse data which provides information from a historical perspective. So we will get data all the previous historical perspective of 5 to 10 years back or 10 to 20 years back. So whatever we need to get, all the details will be getting in the data warehouses stores. So we can call it as a data warehouse is a time variant. So next we can call it as a non-volatile. It doesn't require transaction processing, recovery and concurrency control mechanism. So which requires only two operations in data accessing, initial loading and initial loading of actual data and access of the data. So we can call it as a non-volatile. So other than this data warehouse, simply we say that a collection of heterogeneous or heterogeneous source of data, and we can weave in a single or unified schema. So now there is a difference between operational database systems and warehouses. So here we could take that example of OLTP, online transaction processing, and as well as online analytical processing, that we can compare with that difference between operational data system and warehouses. So here first the key point we should summarize here, the features. First key point is the users and system orientation. So when we consider these key features of the user system and orientation, users and system orientation, so actually they are here. The OLTP is a customer oriented and which is used to, for transaction and query processing by clerk. That is a online transaction processing in a traditional method. So the clerk, client or information technology, whatever the so and so professionals. And OLAP, it is a market oriented and used for data analysis by knowledge workers including manager and executive and a specialist or analyst. So they will have handling. So similarly, another key point, data content. So when we consider these key features, and OLTP manage the current data and typically are too detailed to be used for the decision making. But OLAP, which manages the large amount of historical data, which provides facilities for summarization and aggregation, all will be used here. Next is the database design. So we consider this part, usually an OLTP system which adopt an entity relationship, ER, we know that ER diagram, and data model, and can an application oriented database design, especially in where we are using the traditional system. But OLAP, advanced model schema, or we are using, typically we adopt either star or snowflake model, which we are going to study later. So subject oriented database design, only the subject part we are concentrating, so that we are going to study in the next coming part. Another very important point is the view. So the view, we need to consider that these key features. Actually, an OLTP always focuses mainly on the current data within an enterprise or department, respective organizations, so and so. Similarly, without referring to historical data or in data in the different organizations, that we have to consider in the OLTP system. But OLAP, so in contrast, OLAP system so often spans multiple versions of database schema. So due to the evolutionary process of an organization and so the region. So OLAP system also deal with information that the which originate from different organizations, as well as integrating information from many data stores. So there is a reason because of their huge volume. So OLAP, online analytical processing system, that data are stored on multiple storage media. So when we consider at a view, all the angles, all the viewpoint, we can view the data, but OLTP is not possible. So the last point, key features in the difference between operational database system and data warehouses, when we consider this point, access pattern. So consider this, when we can consider this pattern, OLTP system, which consists mainly of short atomic transactions. Actually, such a system which requires concurrency control and recovery mechanism. So, however, to access to OLAP, the systems which are mostly read-only operations. So, read-only operations means because most of data warehouse stores historic rather than up-to-date information. So, although here many could be a very complex query. Other than this, other features that distinct between OLTP and OLAP systems, which include always in a database size, frequency of operations, and performance metric. So that we can take it in the next table. So before going to that, wow. So why we have a separate data warehouse? So when we are giving answer to this, so operational database store a huge amount of data. So why not perform online analytical processing directly on such databases instead of spending additional time resource to construct a separate data warehouse? This will be the question. So answering to this, operational data, so which contains always a current storage, current data. So whereas this data warehouse will have always the past historical data. So we will get anytime the historical data. So the execution also in OLTP, so that current ODS, operational data structure. So which controls that multiple transaction, whatever the control and recovery mechanism, locking and logging are required to. So always in the robustness of transaction. But whereas in the OLAP query, so need which read only access of data records for summarization, always we can use the aggregation functions or relational algebra. So concurrency control and recovery mechanism, if applied for such a OLAP operations, maybe the execution of concurrent transaction and thus substantially reduce throughput of a particular OLAP system. So like this consideration, finally we say that a separation of operational database from data warehouses based on different structure content, use or size of the data of the data's in this system, decision support which requires always historical data, whereas operational data do not typically maintain historical data. So and so the region. So finally, we need a separate data storage. So that we can call it as a data warehouse. Now we will see that difference or comparison, the distinct between with the help of a key point. So we should consider the features, that is the key feature or key point, we can call it as a key point. So here, comparison between OLTP and OLAP systems. Okay. So now there are certain important features. There are a lot of features will be taken into this consideration, but we have considered these are the list of features that are most probably important features. Characteristic of that, when we compare to this OLTP and OLAP, operational processing, this is informational processing that we need to. Operational processing will be looking to the operations. We are not worry about data, but informational processing, we could think about the what kind of information, data storage. Okay. Orientation, always this is the transaction, just we need to transact it, OLTP. It doesn't worry about other things. But here, what kind of orientation, system orientation will have, OLAP is this analysis. Thinking, or we should think in different perspective, all required. So the end users of this OLTP is the clerk, DBA, database administrator, database professional, obviously this kind of traditional system will have a end users, but OLAP, a knowledge worker, example, manager, executive, and analyst, specialist, all that, who expert, they need to look into this OLAP. The function, day-to-day operation, obviously simple operation of day-to-day OLTP transaction purpose, we are using that OLTP. So, but here, long-term informational requirement and decision support. So, that kind of the function we are going to held in the OLAP. Database design, DB designs, actually it is the entity relationship, ER based, application oriented, current or guaranteed up to date. So, usually we are looking at the day-to-day operations in the case of orientation, current values, current value data will be taking in the design part. We are not taking in the future part or decision making design. But in that OLAP, star or snowflake will be used, because there is a one central fact table. With the fact table, we are going to see the all detailed what kind of the information or any other further details we need. Only the particular process information or one kind of data is required, or large data, or any all the analysis purpose we should take in the star or snowflake. That is subject oriented historical accuracy, which maintained over a time. Summarization. So even consider this key feature, summarization. So a primitive summarization, it is a primitive, highly detailed, okay, as well as the in case of OLAP, again it is a summarized, okay, and consolidated. So this is the primitive in the sense of only the basic ingredient. So primitive, only whatever we used in that, and highly detailed in that primitive data, so which we get highly detailed. But this is OLAP, all summarized, a lot of data will be collected, all summarized, and with respect to consolidated will be getting. Next, view. So when we consider view, so I told that detailed and flat relational will be having in the OLTP. Similarly, so when we look into this view part, summarized and multidimensional, all the dimensional, we will get the all the angles are told that multidimensional in the angles perspective, so that we will get all the details. Next is the unit of work, short simple transaction. So the unit of work will be always a short end because of all the current value, we are considering current value. Complex queries, which we are considering a complex queries in the OLAP, unit of our work. Similarly, access. So access to read and write. So always a read and we can in a OLTP, write operations can be, we can modify whenever the data, because although we are taking the current value data. But in the case of OLAP, mostly read part only we are taking, because the all decision will be taken into the part, so read only data will be taking. So access, okay. Next is focus. Focusing, we are in data in, and this is the data in, we are just concentrating, we are focusing only whether data has got in or not. So in case of OLAP, so mostly we are thinking about information, whether our information has transferred or not, information out, that we are focusing on. Next, kind of operations. The operations index based or has on the primary key we are taking here. In case of OLAP, a lot of a scan. So lot of scan will be used. In that scan, we are thinking about what kind of operation need to be taken. So number of records access. The number of record accessed here, usually tens, and here millions. So this is very, which will come to the size of the particular data thing. Number of users, maybe here 1,000 user, but your number of user is always
less number of user because OLAP 100s, the number of user 100 is enough. Here thousands is required. And size, database size, gigabyte to higher order gigabyte. So GB to higher order GB. So this is always you should take terabyte. You should take it as a terabyte, up to terabyte that we are going to use. So next is the priority. So consider this priority, high performance and high quality. So in case of OLTP transaction, in a priority, when we consider this always a high performance, high availability compared to this, then OLAP priority will be highly high flexibility, end user autonomy. So that we are considering, high flexibility is important in case of high availability or higher performance. Better high flexible is the important. So metrics, what kind of metrics will be used? Transaction throughput. So this is the measures. Usually metrics will be used in the features of the measures. What metrics will be used to measure the how you are going to perform? Performance can be whether in the OLTP or OLAP. So what kind of transaction throughput? So here query throughput. So how many transaction done? Just throughput of transaction, number of transaction, what is we are operated, number of transaction will be calculating. But here query throughput and response time. What is the response time? RTT. Response time will be very good, and with number of query throughput, how many queries will be analyzed or accessed, all the details. So that is the very very specialty of the OLAP. So lot of comparison we have done with the key features. Finally we say that OLAP is far 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 better than OLTP as per the traditional things. So now we are going to discuss a multi-tier architecture of data warehouse. Actually a data warehouse often adopt a three-tier architecture or three-tier architecture. That diagram will be in the next coming slides. First of all, we would discuss about the bottom tier is a warehouse database server that is almost always a relational database system. So here backend tools and utilities are used to feed data into the bottom tier from operational databases or other external sources, such as we can take an example from that customer profile information provided by the external consultant or any other external sources. So we should just feed into the bottom tier. So that is the backend tools and utilities, so that we can take it in the bottom tier. So these tools and utilities perform data extraction, data cleaning and transformation. For example, to merge similar data from different sources into a unified format. So we need to use extraction. Is there any missing or unwanted things? Is there any anomalies that need to be cleaned properly and remove it properly and transform the form, one form to the another form, and merge finally into the unified format. So this is the very important. So as well as load and replace functions always there to update the data warehouse. We'll study it later. The data extracted actually using the application program, so interfaces now we can call it as a gateway. So the gateway, a gateway is always supported by underlying database management system DBMS, and which allows the client program to generate the respective structured query language code, SQL code to be
executed at the server side. So there are examples here. The gateway include ODBC, Open Database Connection, and OLEDB. So object always linking and embedding database. So by Microsoft and JDBC, Java Database Connectivity. So this tier also which contains a metadata repository which always stores information about the data warehouse and with respective content also. The metadata always repository is the further will be discussed in the later slide. So middle tier. So now we are concentrating about after the bottom tier, the middle tier. The middle tier is an OLAP server. Actually, we are talking about all the server here in the middle tier. That is typically implemented using the, we say that using the two cases here, using either one, a relational OLAP, relational online analytical processing system, that we can call it as a ROLAP model. ROLAP model. So that is actually extended relational database management system, extended relational DBMS that maps operations on actually multi-dimensional data to standard operational kind of relational operations. Second one, a multi-dimensional MOLAP. So we can multi-dimensional model, that is a special server. We could call it as a special server here that directly implement multi-dimensional data operations. So OLAP or regarding ROLAP and MLOP, again the we will discuss in the end of this module. So this is about, we said that middle tier of OLAP server. So when we consider this, next part is the third one. So top tier. So third one is the top end layer. We can call it as a top end layer, okay, or top tier. We can call it as this is called as top tier is a front end client layer. So usually we can call it as a front end client layer. So which contains query and reporting tools. So the client can access, or client can ask the different or complex query into this started from this layer or into this layer, and reporting tools also you can access from this, analysis tools also, the lot of analysis tools also available, and or we can say data mining tools. There are a lot of data mining at the front. We say that front end or client layer or front end in the top tier, we will get all the detailed tools we'll be getting. So example here, trend analysis. So that we can take it from this front end client tool. Similarly, prediction analysis, trend analysis, whatsoever, all the detailed things we will get it from the top tier. So this is the three tier. So the once again we say that a bottom tier is a warehouse database server, which is always a relational database system. Because we can, why? Because backend tools and utilities are always used to feed the data that into a bottom tier operational database or other external sources. So that's why we use. Similarly, middle tier is always a regarding server. The functionality of that one, warehouses. The middle tier we will look at it. Typically, so ROLAP as well as MOLAP. and front end. Front end tier which contains reporting tools, all kind of prediction, data mining tools which are available to access or which can be query to the or query from the client. So this is the three tier architecture of or multi tier architecture of data warehouse. Now next slide we will see the diagrammatical representation of this three tier architecture or multi tier architecture. So this is the expected a three tier data warehousing architecture. So multi tier in the sense three tier more than two. So warehouse the data warehousing a multi tier architecture. So first we will see that the symbolical this representation. This is called as operational databases. So now that we have dotted line we have taken below this all we can call it as a simply bottom tier. And from these two and this we can this is called as bottom tier and data warehouse server the starting this called as. So this is the one we have taken here in aroma extract clean transform load and refresh. So there are five functions we use. So these are the data from heterogeneous sources, multiple sources data we are collecting. So this is the back end the bottom tier. So we should do one more process because actually we are collecting from the data flat file or any other disk or any other any kind of external sources. So all the data we are collecting here and we should do this operation is the must. Extract, clean, transform, load and refresh. Why? Because the collected data may be the any format or any kind of data. Data format will be the different. Our data what missing will be might be there in the collected data. We need to clean, transform from actually one format to the another. We should load it and after that refresh. Then this is the feeding into the backend. That is the bottom tiers data warehouse server. So actually here in the bottom tier, this is the data warehouse where data warehouse will be divided into the smallest data mart, which will contain a piece of complete information or small data. We say that data mart will be available. Similarly, metadata repository, all the data details about metadata will have a details. We say that what kind of data will be having. So metadata will having the, we say that metadata are data about data. So the data about data and the metadata repository will have their own structure and operational and what kind of algorithm, summarization use, mapping, which are related to performance, business metadata, all details. So that all the details will be having here. And metadata repository will have this and respective monitoring administrator. We are looking into the data warehouse. So this is about the backend utilities or the backend tier of it. So now come to the in a diagrammatical representation. We are told about in the description OLAP, ROLAP, another one is MOLAP. So this is a middle tier OLAP server. There are two servers we have to think about. One assume that data cube, the data will be in the form as all the relational online analytical processing system as well as multi-dimensional, all the multi-dimensional data view we are getting in the middle tier. That is kind of, we can call it as a middle tier server. Okay. Now we'll be coming to the last front end. So I told that. After that MOLAP and ROLAP, that is the standard relational operations we can multi-dimensional OLAP or a special purpose server that directly implement actually multi-dimensional data and respective operations which we are going to discuss later in the stay in this module. Top tier, see that last one, we are told that why we query processing report or query analysis, and there are top of there might be a data mining tools. So we can do, we could use for trend analysis, prediction analysis, and analysis tool, data mining tools of all available in the front. So there that we can call it a client tier. So the client can directly can communicate to this front end with whatever his requirement. He can query or report, he can access all the details from the he can communicate. So we say that simply communicate to the top tier. So this is actually three tier architecture of data warehouse or data warehousing. So the next videos we are going to discuss a further topic like data warehouse models, enterprises warehouse, mart, the respective topic or content.